I can sing with the birds and the trees in the morning, or roll like the storms way over the ocean. My limit's the sky. I do the impossible, impossible. Shine if I want to. I win every time if I want to. The world mine if I want to. Make the world mine cause I want to. Even on the days when I'm late as ever, my timing is right. Even in the darkest moments, they close, I'm that shining the light. I can make an earthquake nervous, I can make the sun wear a visor. I can make a wise owl see me as a daily advisor. I'm that cool shade, peaceful night, and still my breath is a storm. I bet I can make the thunder clap when I perform. It's just that in the laws of nature, I'm breaking the rules. Only thing I'm bad at is being a loser. Hey, I can make time traveling a surprise. Make graveyards feel alive. Break the immortal down to his demise. I make the moon blue.
Madden Football is the home of Super Bowl 57, and this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the New England Patriots and the New Orleans Saints, and it's coming up next.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. We count on to kick off in what should be an epic one here, as it'll be the AFC champion New England Patriots taking on the NFC champions, the New Orleans Saints. Brandon Gunn alongside Charles Davis. Charles, the Patriots, we know the sequence of events. Tom Brady leaves for Tampa. He wins Super Bowl 55. And the Patriots are kind of middle of the pack for 2 years, but they turn right around, win the AFC title, and now making their record 12th appearance in a Super Bowl.
And I certainly like how you set everything up there, partner, because it certainly felt from the outside that this run of titles was over for this team, that they were going to fall into rebuilding mode. But how about this group? They still believed in themselves, and they made it back to the big game.
Meanwhile, for the New Orleans Saints, what a ride this year under Dennis Allen. He takes over for Sean Payton, instills what seemed to be a new sense of purpose in his players, and they find themselves in the big game for just the second time in franchise history.
Partner, you've got to tip your hat to them, because we remember that string of really tough playoff losses. But how about this franchise persevering? They had a sensational draft, an even better offseason, and they gelled as a unit, and now they have a chance to host the Lombardi Trophy for a second time.
And we will not have a return, so the first drive of the Super Bowl will begin at the 25. So now here come the Patriots to take over on offense. Leading them out, the second-year man from Alabama, Mac Jones.
And I don't think that we can help but recognize the similarity of this moment for Jones to the guy who came before him in New England. In Tom Brady's second season, he led the Pats to the first of 9 Super Bowl appearances in his time there. And now, in his second season with New England, here's Mac Jones leading them out on the biggest stage in sports. Can he follow through tonight and bring New England its record-breaking 7th Super Bowl title? Stay tuned.
And an early how do you do right there as they're going to bury him in the backfield. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Now Jones. And this throw incomplete. The defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. A little trouble thus far on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 11. Throwing Jones. And that is incomplete.
Nice job there forcing that incompletion. This is going to be a fun battle throughout this game, watching him try to take away that area of the field.
Jake Bailey on now to punt here on fourth down. That's taken on the 25. Almost outkicked his coverage there. 48-yard punt, but 10 on the return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. So out comes this offense to take over for the first time.
They're
led out by a three-time Pro Bowler, owner of over 35,000 passing yards in 11 seasons, the veteran Andy Dalton.
As we begin the Super Bowl, we're looking at one of the game's most important players. And whether he's the centerpiece of the offense or taking a backseat to his teammates, offenses always look to the quarterback to be a leader in moments like this. He's got to be that calm, composed pillar out there who stays level-headed and keeps everyone focused on the task at hand.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
Haven't met a corner that's worth the salt yet that ever admits to worrying about man coverage. How about the play there, breaking that pass up?
To throw again on second down, Dalton. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it, and the Pats are going to take possession of the football. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
So back onto the field come the Pats for their second drive. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Even from up here in the booth, the play-by-play guy could tell that there was some pretty good blocking on the right side of the line.
Well, you have good eyes, and it's almost like a ballet when it's executed that well. Everyone in the right spot, everyone in sync, everyone hitting the perfect notes. A little more percussion and a lot more bass, I would think, than you get your normal ballet. But at the same time, that was well executed.
First down, and they go back to Harris. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. Looking to throw. Jones. Throw left side, complete. That's Henry. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10.
The tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. They'll run it. This is Ramondre Stevenson. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Credited with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature in the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Now second and 9 from the 10. Back to throw. Jones. Got a man and he hits him in stride. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll be faced with a third and inches.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. Now Jones, throwing on fourth down, and it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Patriots come up empty on fourth down, and that will force a turnover on downs. So the defense has to stay out and get one more stop. They were able to do it, forcing the incompletion.
So on their record, that goes down as a successful play. Doesn't matter how they got there, how it happened. They got it done. They're the ones that are jubilant.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. They begin on the ground with Kamara, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
And give him a lot of credit there, but even more credit to the guys up front. In that situation, you know it's going to be a stacked defensive front. And to be able to gain that much yardage, that's a big win for the guys on offense.
Yeah, they were just about standing on their own goal line, so to get a few yards there, a great start. Now we'll see what second down brings. Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some push-up. Let's see what they can do on third down. They'll get this out to Kamara. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He missed on his first three passes, was 0 for 3. Now gets a connection, maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern because once you start in a certain pattern, you're wondering, can you get out of it? And that flips the other way, too, when you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion. They think he might be off to the races.
So a little more space to operate now. First and 10 from right around the 12. Play action here with Dalton. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Dalton. That is hauled in by Michael Thomas. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Well, after the standard two-week layoff, you always wonder, how's your offense going to respond and come out and play here in the Super Bowl? Well, they got a great answer right there, and almost a sigh of relief on that side of the field, because now they've got to feel like they can use their entire playbook and game plan for this one.
So that changes things. Here's first and 10 all the way up at the 45. Now Dalton. There again is Thomas. They've gone in a lot. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
And that's how you shake off the interception you throw in the opening drive, come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one. The man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
So into Pats territory now. Here's first and 10 as they've got it to the 28-yard line. Here's Dalton. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
Well, it looked like a march to the end zone. He's hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
On second and 10, Dalton. Here's Johnson with a reception. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Boy, this is a well-orchestrated drive they've put together. You think back to how far they were backed up to start things out, but they've gone on a march since then. And now after that completion there, they've got a first and goal.
A chance for the first score of this Super Bowl. Here's first and goal. Kamara is not going to get a whole lot, maybe a yard down to the 3. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball in this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because...
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Mills. And the Patriots are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line.
Definitely not the ideal time to see that mistake, partner, because this is still a one-possession game, and that's at least a field goal that just vanished with that turnover. Now, pressure's on defensively to prevent that pick from turning into points for the other side.
New England trying to get a place on offense. We've seen both of these offenses still sort of in that figuring things out phase, but I suspect some action on the scoreboard soon as they start out here first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Jones. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
Well, if you have man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Partner, one thing I was lousy at growing up, track and field, I could never anticipate the start before a race. But how about that backer? He figured it out, jumped the count, and turned it into a really nice play for his defense.
Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. Jones on third down. And that will be incomplete.
Well, based on what we've seen so far, I don't think you can even call this an off day anymore, partner, because this group we're watching, they are totally out of rhythm trying to get their game plan up and running. That zero on the scoreboard is glaring down at them with every incompletion.
And the punter Bailey on now as he sends this one away. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And they will take over first and 10. The Saints coming out now to take the field. As the offense comes out here, Charles, remember, they threw the interception last time out, but they were moving the football down the field. Looked like they were going to have a sustained drive that ended in points, but then the pick ensued.
And because of that, there's no way you can call the last drive a success. Yes, there are things to build on because they found some play calls at work. Now, they've got to build another drive and find a way to avoid the turnover the play did on the last one.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. I call it no gain there on the first down play. They couldn't get anything going there out of the right side of the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the
big
passing
emphasis.
Game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
They look to throw on third with Dalton. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. So that'll go as a 4-yard loss on the play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play.
Blake Gillikin on the punt now on fourth down. And look at this. It's a fake, and he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. There are times to run that fake, and there are times to not run it, and this, without question, would fall in the latter category.
Well, I don't know about without question, partner. I think we should look at the analytics on this one because, oh, yeah, the analytics say, yeah, without question. You should have gone ahead and punted the football because now not only did you not get it and you really had no chance to, what a short field that you turned the ball over to the other offense.
Jones now. On first down, over the middle, complete. It's Myers, and he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line. Now a second down and 6. Looking to throw, Jones. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try.
Looks for Parker, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marshon Lattimore. And the Saints are going to get the football back at their own 17. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit. And that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And partner, I know so far, and we're still in the first half, but you love this game as a defensive guy. 0-0. We'll see if the offense can get going on this drive.
Well, you know how they talk about music to your ears? How about what it does for your eyes when you watch something like this, right? When these teams are locked in and going at it, no points going up on the scoreboard. I'm loving it. You're exactly right.
Well, switch over, though, to an offensive mindset for a moment. What do they need to do here to get on track and get some points?
I think a couple of ways. Number one, you pull out something that maybe they haven't seen before. Coaches always talk about unscouted looks. Maybe you give them something that they haven't seen on tape, and now you shock them that way. The second, run your basic playbook, but run it so well that you give your skill position guys a chance to make big plays individually. Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Dalton now to pass. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back to make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Under heavy pressure, and down goes Dalton on the sack. Marching in for the sack, Matthew Judon. So that time, Charles, a quarterback helpless really in the pocket in the face of a pass rush like that. They were on him instantly.
Yeah, that's when we turn to your line and say, guys, can I get a little help here? And you have to ask politely because, remember, they're blocking for you the entire game. But as a quarterback, you've also got to have the clock running in your head when you need to get rid of the football. But this time, he had no chance. They were on him instantly.
And the throw there going to be incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Here's Blake Gillikin now. And deep to return it is Marcus Jones. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive, in particular if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, and some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, their goal is not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Now that after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. They'll try the right side with Harris. And this will be a gain of right around 3 from the 7 out to the 10-yard line. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35. Well, fair to say that when you're looking at guys that can run like the wind, you often find them at the wide receiver position, and that was special there.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterwards. So just give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
And if you're wondering how fast he was going, next-gen stats clocked him at close to 21 miles an hour. Here's Jones on first and 10. And this one complete to Smith. And they'll work this down inside the 30. On second down, this is Harris. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop it behind the line. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. To throw. Jones got his man complete over the middle. It's Myers, and they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. So the completion good for 6 yards, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be fourth and short.
So on fourth down, Jones jogs off, and on comes a longtime vet, Nick Folk, for the Pats field goal try. And the former Arizona Wildcat, Folk, gets this one to go, and the Patriots jump out to a 3-0 lead. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one-possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
Take it in at the 3. How does the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here? This one a little slow to get cooking. Just a 3-0 scoreline as they begin with a 1st and 10. It's Dalton. His throw incomplete.
Well, he's seen him catch a few passes out of the backfield in the first half. Unable to connect on that one.
Certainly seems like getting in the ball in a passing game, though, is part of their game plan.
It certainly is, because he catches it well, creates a mismatch. You're going to cover him with a linebacker, a corner, a safety. They feel like he...
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it, and the Pats are going to take possession of the football. 3 first-half interceptions now, and Charles, you'd have to think a fair amount of concern is developing over there on that sideline.
And there should be, because essentially he's been a little loose and possibly reckless with the football here in the first half. Now, maybe it's not all on him, but still 3 interceptions. That puts the entire team in jeopardy. So the play caller from here on out, got to design some throws for him that he can complete, keep it away from the defense, and try and get him back on track.
Now Jones, throwing to start the drive.
And this one almost intercepted. Had a chance to come down with it in the end zone, but could not hang on.
Run with Harris out of the shotgun. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Jones to throw on third down. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Myers. And he is out of bounds. Looks like right at the 15. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards. And it'll be fourth down.
And that's going to be a tough one to explain when they get together to watch the game film, isn't it? I mean, they had the right call, had the out route. He's got to know where the first down sticks are. Yet he steps out of bounds that close. Not their best play.
They're going for it. This is Harris. And he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. The Patriots come up empty on fourth down. And the Saints will have the football back. And they've now made 2 trips to the red zone and still looking for their first touchdown.
Not able to punch it in. And if you're on defense, your confidence is sky high. Because mentally, you're saying, hey, you're in the red zone. We're thinking we're giving up 3. We just want to give up 6. In this case, they end up not giving up the touchdown at all. They've got to feel great about what they got done.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And this is going to fall to the ground incomplete. That very nearly their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. From the gun, Dalton looks to throw. Downfield throw tip, but he still got it. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. That one good for 26 and a first down.
When we see the ball tipped in the air, sometimes we get a little roll change, don't we? Because when it's in the air, sometimes the defensive back becomes the receiver. And in this case, the receiver looked like a defensive back, but ended up a receiver.
He caught it as a receiver. Hey, it worked out.
Worked out really well for them. But I'm telling you, the defensive guys.
Frustrated.
Oh, frustrated. They're going to catch it in film.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. So Dalton now. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line. Throwing, Dalton. And he'll go right back to Thomas, complete again. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. They go right back to him for 20 and a first.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. This will be Dalton again. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense have other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Play action. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. Devin McCourty picks it off. And the Patriots are going to have it here at their own 9-yard line. Well, CD, you know, when you mentioned earlier about spreading the ball around in this game, I don't think you mentioned the guys in the other uniform. With 4 interceptions here in the first half, and several different guys have picked them off.
Yeah, instead of analyzing what's going wrong with him, throwing the football. While we look at the defense, they came in prepared, had excellent game plan, well scouted, and they're taking it away at almost every turn.
Throwing to start the drive. Jones. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense.
Understandably, pass rushers keyed up for this Super Bowl, but you can't do that.
And let's face it, no one wants to lose one of these quarterbacks early in this game, so you know they're going to be protected by the officials.
Now a give, running left is Harris, and he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. On second and 12, Jones, he's going to sling this deep downfield. He's got a man complete. And he's going to be taken down, but there's a penalty flag in the backfield. Is this a hold or did they rush the quarterback? So a little extra on top of the big play there.
It's tough for guys rushing the passer, but you have to know when the ball is gone. And if you listen, officials will tell you ball's gone. He didn't pull up.
Jones now throwing on first down. This is caught and out of bounds all the way down at the 3. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
Looking to throw. Jones. Hunter Henry from 3 yards out, and they are able to add on to their advantage.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury, and it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. They find themselves open for an easy touchdown.
Nick Fulton for the point after. It's picked up, a live ball here, and now the rookie's free. He's at the 40, the 20, and he dives into the end zone and gets the 2 points. Well, you figure with a veteran kicker out there, these extra points almost automatic, but this one turns into 2 points the other way.
And we both know it's hard to put it on him. I think there's a breakdown in the protection, but guess what? It does go against his record.
So after the block PAT, they're ready to kick this one off. Taken in at the 3. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. The New Orleans offense set to take over. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Dalton sets up play action. Thomas brings it in. And out across midfield down to the 45. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. First and 10 for Dalton. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
Looked like the screen pass was taken away there, but what a nice job improvising, finding other options, and completing the pass anyway.
Search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. To throw here, Dalton. And that is incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They give him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one as it's good from 56 yards out. And that'll bring him back within four.
Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gain something out of that drive.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
So we've come upon halftime in the big one, the Super Bowl. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome everyone to our brand new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports Halftime Report. First things first, though, let's get a check on the next-gen stats from that first half for New England. And it's been the passing game that's gotten them to where they are. Two quarters away from a possible Super Bowl title. Meanwhile, for the Saints, they were even better throwing the football. Lots of open receivers to choose from, and you can bet that'll continue to be a focus in the second half.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. Taken in at the three. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. And they trail here in the Super Bowl, but fortunately for them, Charles, very much still within striking range.
Yeah, things didn't go exactly the way they planned in the first half. To me, they appeared to be a little bit tight, made a few errors they normally wouldn't. But, of course, this is the Super Bowl, so things get a little bit heightened in that regard. But I think they have to feel a little fortunate. They're only down what they are here starting the third quarter.
Dalton, first and 10. Drops this off to Kamara out of the backfield. So just 3 yards on the completion there. And it'll be second down. And Dalton to throw. Back to Kamara for another catch. Oh, it's a nickel set here defensively on third and inches.
Still want to be prepared for a pass.
Andy Dalton. And that's knocked away and incomplete.
This is just a continuation of what we said in the first half. So much for the fresh start to begin. No touchdown scored in this game.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. And this one hits at the three and then bounces into the end zone for a touchback. So here are the Patriots now. They get ready for their first possession of half number two. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Throwing, Jones, and caught by Henry. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about if I worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Now Jones. Got a man open. That's Devontae Parker complete. And they're going to get this up to midfield.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He'll find Parker again, complete. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. Looking to throw again on second down. Jones. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. So this offense moving the ball well, trying to open up a two-score lead here in the third quarter, but now potentially a play that could have big ramifications.
Yeah, you've driven the ball down the field. Things are looking up, but it takes just one bad decision to throw things off the rails.
Set to take over once again. Out comes the Saints offense. They'll start in excellent field position following the INT. So a good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 44. Their D gets the INT. Now what can Dalton do? This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
Hold on a second. Was that the fullback? That was the fullback. Who says that the slot receivers are the only guys who catch the football and get big yardage after the catch? Really nice job there. Showing good hands and an ability to get upfield.
A first and 10 at the 38. Here's Dalton. He completes it to Olave. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Now what we're seeing, this is much better from this offense because so far in this game, no touchdown to this point. And what's usually a direct correlation? Very few explosive plays. That's been their issue. Not able to make that big shot downfield or break one off, but a nice game there for a first down.
Try to pound it in, Kamara. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up 2nd and goal.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, you pointed out to me at half, seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on 3rd and goal. They'll run it with Kamara, and he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down about the 2-yard line. Only a yard there, so it brings up 4th and goal.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Just a 19-yard attempt. The kick by Lutz is good, and that'll bring him back within a point. Well, the 3 points certainly helps, but you feel like, Charles, at this stage of the game, when you force those turnovers, you need to start converting them into touchdowns.
Yeah, I'm a little bit surprised myself because I thought in this situation, they were thinking end zone or bust. Now they got to rely on their defense to get the ball back again for another opportunity to get 6 points.
And this will come out to the 25 as Jones elects for the touchback. New England's offense set to go.
As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in the second half.
They hand this off to Harris, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. Here's Jones on 3rd down. And that will be incomplete.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the 3 and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
New Orleans offense back out and ready to go. This game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
Got to be careful here, Dalton. Olave over the middle. And they work this out past the 25. 25 yards there on the catch and run.
And they were backed up to start the drive, but not anymore. Now, that's the play call that the offensive coordinator had in his head. You saw the end result. He wanted to go ahead and push the ball downfield, and that's what they did. And they wound up with good yardage there to get things rolling.
On 1st and 10, here's Andy Dalton. He'll rifle this one deep right side. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
But based on the play we just saw there, he might not be the guy you want to challenge in coverage on these all-important snaps. He certainly looks dialed in right now.
To throw on 2nd and 10, Dalton. And he slings one that's incomplete.
Right now, the story of this game continuing to be the defenses, because the offenses, they're finding it difficult to establish any rhythm whatsoever.
I like how you come to us in praise of defense, Brandon, because that's exactly right. That was an incompletion force there, but we've seen it throughout this game. Both of these defense coordinators, they're a step ahead of their offensive counterparts.
Well, he's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'll guarantee he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield, because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
Oh, the return is Jones. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And the Patriots take over.
New England trying to get a place on offense.
And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive.
Stevenson gets it again on second down.
Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of four.
Well, you certainly have to give them a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
They set up the screen for Stevenson.
And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play call, since the screen pass was available, whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
Now Jones on first down. That ball's caught. Aguilar right side.
And not much happening there. He's taken down, but a late penalty flag in the backfield. This looks like a roughing call. Well, that flag puts them on their heels a little bit more defensively as the officials walk it upfield.
Yeah, and they can blame the officials all they want, but bottom line, it's their own fault, because to me, that was an avoidable call. Stay focused and avoid major mistakes like that.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Third quarter action in Super Bowl 57. Here's a second and 10.
To throw again, Jones.
And that falls to the ground, incomplete.
A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. Back to throw again. Open man is Kendrick Bourne. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 28. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the third downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the third quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
Again, he'll drop the throw. This complete left side to Aguilar. Touchdown, Patriots! Nelson Aguilar, 28 yards.
And the Patriots are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter.
Man, he just ran a terrific route. Extremely hard to defend when it's run that precisely and the ball's delivered that accurately.
Extra point is Folk. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. So that drives seven plays in length.
And it was capped by the touchdown pass to Nelson Aguilar.
Folk now set to boot it after his guys put six on the board.
Fields it right around the goal line. A
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. The last series for them, a little disappointing, forced to punt. And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10. And only able to get two here, stopped at the 30. Just one more quarter remains in the season-long race for the Lombardi Trophy here at Super Bowl 57 from Glendale. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Folks, welcome back to the biggest stage in sports, the Super Bowl, and now we get down to the good stuff, the fourth and final quarter. Throwing again on second down. Dalton, a quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand. And that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
He's got him in. Complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That goes as a gain of 36 on third down. What a game it's been for this duo.
They remind me of a good comedy team. They know how to play off of each other so well. No matter how one riffs, the other's right there to pick them up, and they are shredding them in this ballgame.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Here's Dalton. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play. One that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. And it'll be Dalton again. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
Article, once in my life, I'll be succinct. In a one-possession game, every single stop like that could be a difference maker.
Third down, a shot here for Dalton. And that will be incomplete as well.
I think it's safe to say that he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Forced some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now, but he was fortunate on that one not to have another turnover on his ledger.
The kick by Lutz is good, and that'll get the lead down to 5. So an interesting call there to take the 3, and I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
No run back here for Jones, a touchback. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And the tension ratcheting up all around. A one-score game, fourth quarter of the Super Bowl. This is what you folks came for. Every play with the potential to win or lose a title as they look to drain some time off this clock. Jones throwing to start the drive. And he's taken down here by the Saints. He couldn't get rid of it. He takes a sack for a loss of 6 to bring up second down. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DM.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Another try after the first down sack. Jones. This will be a short gain of 3 before he's brought down at the 22. New England on third down. They're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. This is going to be third and 13. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
It'll go as a 50-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over. Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. And we're at the time of this Super Bowl where, look, they need points. And they need them badly, trailing here in the fourth quarter as they begin this drive first and 10. They'll get this out to Kamara. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner. We watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
Dalton with a first and 10. Complete. It's Johnson. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Dalton here from the gun. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try to pick up another first down.
And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Play fake. Here's Dalton. Here's Johnson with a reception. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 16. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Dalton operating in the red zone now. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown in. Frankly, that should have been another pick right there. The pickup goes for 13 and sets him up first and goal.
The drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far in this drive, so good. They moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively, but they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. So Dalton now, and it's caught. Touchdown, Saints. Michael Thomas from 4 yards out. And the Saints have regained the lead in the second half of the Super Bowl.
And that touchdown ends a streak, for lack of a better word, of 3 field goals that they put on the board previously. They finally cracked the code.
Yeah, they've been down there. They've been in enemy territory, as you said. They just haven't been able to punch it in until that point. Big spot now for the Saints as they'll indeed go for two. Dalton to throw for. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. So that effort gives them a three-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy because that's all you care about. Not getting beat at this stage. At least give your team a fighting chance.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And this will come out to the 25 as Jones elects for the touchback.
The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field.
And this could become a career-defining drive for some. Down three, fourth quarter of the Super Bowl. This is where the legends are made in the National Football League as they begin this drive first and 10.
Throwing Jones. He gets it complete to Harris. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. Second and six, just inside of the 30. On the give, this is Harris. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. They're able to convert with a gain of four.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now Jones. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
To throw once more on second and 10. Jones, he's got it complete to Aguilar. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down.
That's a pretty throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. A really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big time arm strength. Very nice route.
Jones now on first and 10. Looking sideline, incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, out back on their heels, but they're in a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Throwing again on second and 10. Jones dancing to his left. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Well, certainly those are the types of mistakes they're trying to avoid as they attempt to protect this lead late in the game.
And let's face it, they're hoping that this one doesn't cost them in a significant way. Yeah, one guy committed a penalty, but now the entire defense has to pay the price and try to rise up and overcome it.
And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. From the 22, Jones. It's Myers again with another catch. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Out of the gun, they give it to Stevenson.
And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Oftentimes, when you see a running back get punched up in the backfield, it's usually because the defensive tackle is eating up blockers for others to make the play. Not in this case.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Harris running straight ahead. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
It's not easy playing the corner, is it? A lot of times you got to defend against the pass, but sometimes you have to play against the run. How about a job he did there, crashing inside to make that tackle for a loss?
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. He hit his first, this one from 38. And the former Arizona Wildcat, Folk, gets this one to go. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. Now, we knew this had the potential to be a tight game, but with less than 3 minutes to play, couldn't be any tighter. We're all tied.
All locked up, right? And this next drive's going to tell us everything we need to know about this game, because I want to see how they come out with the football. Are they going to be aggressive and attack downfield? You still got the 2 minute warning to come up. Are they going to be conservative and try and hold on and maybe just get to overtime?
And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line.
So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started.
A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partners, a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now, but let's give credit where it's due, because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
And because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football.
5 yards remain on second down. Dalton. Now, quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
A couple extra defensive backs out there in the dime, and because of that, really not many places to throw the football, if any.
And typically, what would you want to do against that dime?
Run the football.
You want to run the ball, but you can't do it in this situation.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here comes the Saints punter now, standing right on his own 5-yard line. A big boot that time, 57 yards the official distance.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over. New England's offense set to go.
Well, partner, here it is. They've got the chance to win the game. You'd have to think they need to get it near the opposite 40 to have a chance to kick a game-winning field goal. We'll see what they can do.
And you're right about that, because if we look at it in macro, that's what it looks like. But I think in micro, the head coach has already asked the special teams coach, what is he feeling? What does he think? Where does he want the football? What's the yard line we have to get? And he's already relayed that to his quarterback and his offense. They know what the goal is. Now the key, can they get there?
They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. To throw is Jones. And this is going to be intercepted. Marcus May with a pick. And the Saints are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield.
We say it often, Charles, but not all interceptions are created equally, and that is is a big one here in a tie ball game in the fourth quarter.
And Brandon, when games are this close, it usually comes down to the team making the fewest mistakes. And that was one of our mantras back in Tennessee. Coach Major say all the time, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. You've got to cut those down to give yourself an opportunity.
A good starting spot for the Saints as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 49. Here's Dalton. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four.
Well, that answers the question in my head. They're going to go for the win right now.
I think you're absolutely right. They're not content with going OT. Now Dalton. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over at that time, and it's going to lead to third down. Chris Olave, the intended receiver. And that'll make it third down. They need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing. Dalton wants to throw. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock.
A little bit of a dangerous throw in a tie ball game because your job, make sure the worst thing that happens to your offense is that you go into overtime. That could have been a game changer there if he came down with that interception.
Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. The Pats at the line ready to go.
And Charles, obviously not much time left. I'm curious to see if there's enough for them to get into field goal range and try to win this thing.
And partner, you and I both know the safe calls to kneel and just take it into overtime. But it's also very tough to pass up a chance to win it right now as well. But remember, if you do attempt that, it's got to be a big play downfield and still leave yourself enough time to get your field goal unit out there and kick for the win.
Super Bowl, something the Patriots know all about, and they'll once again get the ball first as we start this overtime session. And we will not see a return to start overtime. It'll come out to the 25-yard line.
So the Patriots coming out now.
And CD, we get to see the debut of the brand new postseason overtime rules. Now, as everybody is learning, both teams are going to be guaranteed an offensive possession. So they might get the ball first here, but a touchdown does not right away win the game.
And we saw many marker games along the way that sparked a lot of conversation. But the Buffalo-Kansas City game in the 2022 playoffs, that really brought about this rule change. What an amazing game, a true classic. Ended in overtime without Buffalo getting a shot with the football, and the people didn't like that at all. So starting this season, if you make the playoffs, you'll get a chance to answer if the other team scores first. And that way, you get a chance to keep a great game as well as your hopes alive as you chase the big prize.
A touchdown would obviously be ideal to start this overtime. They'd still need to play defense, but it's first and 10.
Back to throw. Jones. It's caught by Aguilar. Overtime here out west, and you got a team from the Eastern time zone. Maybe their body clock's a little thrown off, or is that overhype?
I don't think it's overhype, and I think that for most teams, you're hoping that your mind overrules your body because your body's looking for slippers and bedtime clothes, right? They're looking for the pajamas. But in this case, you've got to stay with it mentally. And what a lot of teams do, they never change their watches. They always say on East Coast time and just go ahead that way to try and defeat any of the effects of moving to the West.
From the midfield. midfield stripe. They'll look to throw. It gets it into the arms of Parker. Complete. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. And you definitely could make the case we might not even be in overtime had he not thrown three interceptions in regulation. But looking better here so far in OT.
Yeah, and when you think about what a coach is thinking at that point, because normally you've thrown three picks during the game, you might craft your play calling to be a little more careful. Not in this case. The green light still on for him.
They are into field goal range, but definitely thinking touchdown as they come up first and 10. Looking to throw. Jones. And right side, Henry's got him. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. And the ball on the 30 here, 2nd and 4. Back to throw. Jones. And that'll be incomplete. He was out there waving his arms saying, throw it here, dropped it, not a good ball.
Well, all I can do is just look at him with contempt on that one. As a defensive back, I'm saying, not as an announcer. Just like, really?
A little bit of a diva look, isn't it?
Yeah, very much so. Because I think what happens is he just had too much time to think. He's wide open now. Here comes the ball. And he doesn't concentrate, drops it.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the third row.
They're able to put 3 on the board here on the opening drive of OT and now up to their defense to try and see if they can hold this one.
I like how you framed it up because obviously this game is not over, right? They go down and kick a field goal, then we head to sudden death. But if the defense can hold it, take the ball away, turn it over on downs, this game's over.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. And now the Saints get set to trot out there. See if they can put this drive in the end zone, Charles, because it's been a little bit of a rough go at times. They've had to punt the football a ton in this ball game because of stalled out drives.
So are you saying that you're kind of tired of seeing the punter run out there and do his thing during this game? Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm okay with it. I have a feeling that this offense, they don't want to see the punter again.
And frankly, the punter doesn't want to run out there anymore himself. He'd love to see his offense put together a drive and give his leg a rest.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
To throw again on 2nd down, Dalton. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down. Nervous time now. Moving the chains. An absolute must. Here's 3rd down. Passing. It's Dalton. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong. And now it's 4th down. They'll try to pass on 4th down. Dalton. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And the Patriots take over. They're going to have terrific field position. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on 4th down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen, you and I both in the practices where we've seen, hey, 3rd down situation, big 3rd down alert, lock in here, 4th down play, make sure you're focused just a little bit extra. It didn't pay off in that situation.
And it's another Super Bowl title for the New England Patriots. And to the Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. It actually gave me chills just to hear you say that because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.